Anyway, time to introduce not only a living legend in entertainment, but also a personal great in my life. The one, the only, there'll never be another, Hammer! Hammer. Great personal pleasure.
Yeah, you got to grab hold of yourself, partner.
Really? Grab hold where? Oh, I said like this. Like that. As you can see, I came to see your show last time you played over about 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Fantastic show. What's been happening since then?
A whole lot. You know, actually, since then...
Stop.
Hammer time.
I'm sorry about that. What can we do? Stop!
Hammer time!
I can do it all night!
All right. I ain't saying that now.
No, come on. Because since we last saw you, a completely new image. Oh, it was not... Hammer, you can't... Apparently you're not mic'd up. You should have known about that. What has been happening since we last saw you? Complete new image.
I ain't saying that. I don't know, man. You know, you might cut me off.
No, I won't. All I'm going to do is go, stop.
Hammer time.
That's all I'm going to do. That's the most I can do. I promise I won't do it again for at least 2 questions.
Okay, at least 2?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you know, I've been getting the new album ready, The Funky Headhunter, you know, working out a lot, chilling. I guess I chilled for about 15 months. I came off tour in 92.
Well, we actually got a clip from your video. It's, cool. It's all good. So let's have a quick look at that. Hammer's new. Stuff done very well with the crowd, as you can see. What prompted the whole change of style? Was it the sort of gangster look that's very popular at the moment?
No, I didn't want to come out like you. See, like, you know, in 91, that was all right. 1988, 89, but, you know, I wouldn't be called dead in them.
You're not telling me I look unfashionable now, are you?
No, you know, I wouldn't come out.
How dare you laugh at me for wearing these? They're all pretty.
Hey,
cool.
You need to get updated, partner. This is 94. You know, it's like, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, it's my face red now. No, but what did? I mean, I can always do this. Stop.
Hammer time.
Oh, I missed out there.
You can't touch me.
Now, what has happened, because I know that tracks on your new album were produced by Daz and Corrupt from the Dog Pound.
Yeah,
but surely
yeah.
That whole gangster image is completely against what you're all about, because, you know, you're a Christian and all that business.
Well, they're not gangsters, you know. They rap about hardcore subjects, but, you know, I don't know no gangsters who make rap records, you know. I know some gangsters who run some record companies, but not, you know, not making rap records, but they rap about hardcore subjects, you know. I think the term gangster rap is something like... you know, media-made type of thing, because people have been doing hardcore raps for a long time, you know, it's not nothing new. Just the term gangster rap just kind of, like, blows it out of proportion a little bit.
But don't you find there are a lot of negative images in other people's rap, not yours at all?
I don't know. It depends on, you know, how you look at it. That's the reality, you know what I'm saying? What you see Snoop rapping about is where Snoop lived and hung out. He's rapping about what he knows, so I don't see that being negative. I see that there needs to be a change in his environment, you know what I'm saying? Some employment, some, you know, some education, some recreation, and then maybe he'll have something else to rap about, but he's rapping about what he knows.
But surely, when he says things like, never hesitate to put a nigger on his back, surely that's not a positive image?
Positive image, no, but I know what he's referring to. In certain situations, right, if somebody steps to you and you have to handle your business, it's not necessarily a nigger on his back, it's anybody, you know?
I think what you're saying now is that I'm on your back.
Well, you know, if you step to me, I'll put you on your back, at least off the camera.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to stop.
Hammer time.
I'll have to stop you now and go from one showbiz legend to another. Terry, I'll talk to you later on.
I'll do anything to be on TV.
Well done, Hazel. You're a star.
I know you've got a management company in America, haven't you?
Something like that.
Do you think that might be one of the stars of the future? Maybe you'll be looking after?
Oh, man. She's pretty bold, though, you know. I don't know. She'd do anything to be on TV.
You're right there.
Yeah. I want to talk about your new video, which isn't going to be out over here for a while yet, but is it Pumps and a Bump?
Yeah, Pumps and a Bump.
In which you the Christian, I don't know, figurehead in American rap.
No, don't call me that. Not the Christian figurehead.
Well, you're the only Christian rapper I can think of offhand. No, well, one DMC.
That's not a fair assessment. I'm a person who got my own spiritual beliefs, but it's not, don't call me a Christian rapper.
Okay, you are a Christian and you're a rapper. I'll separate you that way. And in it, you're dancing around with hundreds of very beautiful women.
About 400.
About 400, exactly.
About 400.
Over here, we have a singer called Cliff Richard. I don't know if you're aware of him. And he would never, he's very well-known Christian, and he would never have a scantily clad woman in his video. Do you think American Christians are just more up for a laugh, basically?
No, I don't know. I think, religion and, all that's an individual thing. You know, each person, you can't throw nobody, your beliefs off on anybody else. Me, my thing is personal, you know what I'm saying? But
it's
as
not
far as me
video.
Being surrounded with women, oh, I love that all day long. Yeah,
it
I
does
love
show
that.
In the video. It does, we can't show it, sadly, but it does show that you love that.
Yeah, I love that.
Coming up after the break, we've got Terry talking to Malcolm Jamal Warner. Bone will be doing their stuff, and I promise I won't say stop.
Have a time.